Jam on toast!
Hey guys, it's me, John. So, I was at a friend's house the other day, and I was watching Shark Week. Yes, everybody knows it's an amazing thing in the U.S. Shark Week! Guess what? It has been taken over by the industry. You know, it was a Discovery Channel thing. It used to be a Discovery Channel thing that, you know, was trying to help people understand sharks, not be so afraid of sharks, etc., etc. Now, every 5 minutes, it was Foster's Beer. So it's been commercialized, and just like everything else that has anything good in this world to watch, then it's been commercialized. So I'm very disappointed that Shark Week is now, you know, commercialized, and Foster's Beer is the sponsor of Shark Week. But, you know, what can you say? I also watched another show. It was called Animals Extreme. And it was showing the top 10 animals that had ideas or work in their natural habitat. And humans have taken their ideas and claimed them of their own. For an instance, the wasp. It's been building its nest out of paper for millions of years. And just within a few decades, we started using paper. And it was thought of by a guy from China who was watching a wasp build his nest. And he decided that it would be a good idea to make paper. And then now we have paper and everything is used by paper. So wasps, awesome. You know, we're taking after animals and you just never thought that, you know, people would steal ideas and be like, let's patent this, and, you know, nature's already been doing it. Another really cool thing that I found out from that show is that the number one animal on the extreme is the wood frog. And the reason why it was number one is because it does things that only we can do in TV shows. I know we're working on it, but it can freeze itself, like in the wintertime, it'll freeze itself, like completely, like a block of ice. And then whenever spring or anything else comes around, it'll thaw itself out and it'll restart its heart. So it's doing a cryo freeze that we are trying to do now that we have no luck with right now. So it's interesting to see that, you know, how animals affect our lives. But, Cam, just to let you know, about the console thing, I agree that a console is just a huge computer, and I think that it would be ideal if we got rid of them and just used our computers for everything. But unfortunately, I don't think the console is coming to an end by any means. There's too many people out there that are lazy, and they don't want to go and figure out what they need on their own. So I think that continually, consoles will last for a long time. At least until, you know, we get holograms. I hope you enjoyed everything. I hope you gained a little bit of insight and a little bit of knowledge. But as always, I'm John, and y'all keep sticking with us.